In this moment, we want to celebrate the life of a few friends who really did become the best they could in the short time they had with us. We dedicate this third day to Gabriela from Brazil and Noel from the Philippines. Gabriela was born in Caruaru, Pernambuco, Brazil, in November 6 of 1996. She had a smile that captivated people she met and transmitted a unique light. She had this amazing capacity on continue on with life despite going through something really difficult. She would always say that we need to love always, immediately, and with joy. I remember how happy she was. She was in the last years of her studies to become a dentist. Some days before the accident, she was attending to a patient who needed to go through a really difficult operation. The patient was apprehensive and afraid, so to calm her down, Gabi sang during the whole process. This was her way to love, giving herself completely in the present moment. It was so important for her to do her best in each moment, whether it was studying or helping the mom around the house or simply going out with friends. She was always so ready to love.
I met Noel when we were still young. He was the drummer of a band. And as a kid who was dreaming to play in a band, I'd always go and watch them play. At first, Noel was very intimidating because of how he dressed. However, he would be the first one who'd approach you and initiate a conversation with you. We became closer when I joined the band. And I remember during one of the practices, he would tell me, Jay, don't be shy. Let them hear your voice. Sing from the heart. And sing not for yourself, but for all the youth. Noel was the perfect example of seeing everything with new eyes. I remember one time he had a heated argument with someone. Oh no. Okay, with someone. Some words were said to him that were not true. And we really felt that this person was really trying to hurt him, no? So as his friend, I stood by his side and I supported him. And then before going to bed, I remember I was thinking to myself, Noel won't forgive that person easily. He won't forgive him, no? And to my surprise, the very next day, I saw Noel talking to this person and they are having a great time together. So I asked, Noel, what happened? And he simply replied, Jay, it's nothing. The most important thing is to love and to love. This really struck me because if I were in that position, it would really be hard for me to forgive, no? He was one of my best friends. Probably one of the best people I've ever met.
To those who didn't know him personally, let me try to tell you who Noel was for me. Noel was at different points of my life, my bandmate, my best friend, my boyfriend, my ex-boyfriend, and my teammate for GenFest work. During our relationship, he did his best to try and understand the complex, reserved, and tight-lipped person that I was. And although he apologized for our relationship being a bumpy ride, I knew that I was the one with a roller coaster of emotions. However, during and even after our relationship, I had learned many things, such as not giving up and letting go, about loving my family, about how it's okay to cry, about understanding that life is short, and that we must live simply and take all our chances to forgive and apologize and say our I love yous. Later, more than a year after breaking up, I found out that we could become even better friends away from an intimate relationship. The last time we saw each other was at a meeting to prepare for the ChenFest. I am glad that we were able to spend time joking with each other, drinking coffee, eating good food with others, and just being the happy youth that we are. He never failed to tell me he'd be there for me if I need any help. After bidding him our last goodbyes at his cremation and funeral, after beating his drum, after finally accompanying him to his resting place, I felt an odd sense of peacefulness. It was the festive celebration that Noel wanted. I treasure our years of friendship and love, and I will always keep him in my heart.